My name is Ishelle Deboe. I'm connected to this project because they're doing it on my great-great-grandma.
My name is Dennis Wounders Hill, and I'm connected to this project as an artist in the community.
My name's Olivia Levins Holden. I'm a community health and resilience organizer at Hope Community, and I also am the coordinator for the Power of Vision mural project, which this mural is a project of. So my role in this project has been to coordinate it and also as one of the three collaborating artists on the project. I was asked about the idea of doing a mural in the Jourdain community room when I first started at Hope a couple of years ago, and immediately thought of, you know, the question of who was Winnie Jourdain.
Winnie Jourdain, she was born in the 1900s. She came to the cities during like the relocation period with her husband, and they lived on the house right where Hope Community is now. And she was just like a community organizer. She just believed in helping people and like doing whatever you could. She was very selfless. She lived by tradition.
I learned a lot about her, and I was kind of amazed by her, her life story.
So Winnie Jourdain was a very important figure in the Phillips neighborhood history. She lived right at the intersection of Portland and Franklin Avenue. In fact, the building that we're in right now is named after her. And Hope Community purchased the land for the primary office, the Children's Village building, from her. That's where her house was located. So over the 60 or so years that she lived in Phillips neighborhood, Winnie Jourdain opened her home to hundreds of people coming from different parts of the state when they first arrived here and needed a place to stay. She worked to bring people together and offer resources where there really weren't resources for the Native community. And she did this in a lot of different ways. I started doing some research and, you know, started learning more about her impact here in Phillips. And then through a little bit more research about Winnie, I identified that one of our youth mural interns, Ishelle Deboe, is in fact Winnie Jourdain's great-great-granddaughter, who, and she's also, you know, a young artist coming up into her skill and leadership and voice, and somebody that I was excited to work with. And so the three of us became the core artists on the project, and it's been a real great collaboration.
I think she was important because she was doing something that seemed kind of like impossible in a way, because people, you get so like put down by like the system and where you're at in life, and she didn't let that stop her. And she was like, I'm gonna take the little that I have and the little people I know, and we're gonna resource this, and we're gonna do what we can, basically. And from that, she built a lot, and she helped a lot of people.
And so this project feels important to me because I believe that the people that, you know, have made an impact on our communities deserve to be honored for that work. And, you know, we stand on the shoulders of those who came before us and those who worked and dedicated their time and their energy and their care to making our communities stronger and more resilient.
To me, it's important because I feel like I'm contributing to the community in a positive way.
So it's a very proud moment for me to see like her legacy live on. So the mural process started a year ago, and it was just us three with Shaka, like just talking about why we wanted to be a part of the project, getting our feelings out there, and then we went from there, like on the research part. And then from that, we were like, okay, what images, what colors, what do we want to make people feel? We did some sort of community engagement when we went to tea. And then from that, we just created the template, and then that's what created this. We We have her stitching something onto a quilt because that was one of her main hobbies, and also how she did like some of the organizing to raise money. We have the trees in the background and the lake because that's actually the lake that the house was built on. We have her picking berries because that's another one of the main things she did. Up until she couldn't even do it herself, she just had my mom do it for her and she would just go along for the ride. And then the image of her teaching is actually because she was the first Ojibwe teacher at the U of M, so we wanted to show that. And then the Scrabble game was just another fun hobby thing to show. The medallions there because she actually, I forget the exact number, but when the Olympics were here in the, what, like 50s or 60s, she actually gave some to the Pope of Norway, I think it was. So that's cool, so we wanted to show a medallion. And then the cup, which is there, and also on the Scrabble table, both are labeled Ma because that's what she labeled everything in our house was Ma.
When people see the mural, I want them to, even if it's not a full picture of who Winnie Jourdain was, I want them to get a sense of who she was and what she did here. And I want them to feel inspired. I think that the design shows some of the things she did and some of the ways that she influenced other people, and that her influence then rippled out and continues to be present here in Phillips. So I want people to feel that and understand, a little bit about who she was.
When they look at it, I want them to know that what she done as a person can be done by anybody, you know. And I hope she influenced, by looking at it, she can influence other people to do what she did.
I just want people to feel inspired, because literally we're all just reflections of each other. So like when they see this, I want them to see the story and just be like, wow, okay, I've had hardship in my life. I've gone through this. I don't have much, but I do have this resource. What can I do with that? I want them to take away motivation to like fix what they want to get fixed. And to also be more a part of their community, because that's what this mural and just being part of like the whole murals have made me, is wanting to become more a part of the community.
No, I'm hopeful, yes I am hopeful for today. Take this music and use it, let it take you away. And be hopeful, hopeful, and he'll make a way. I know.